Let's enter into today's subject. So many days we did not have such some. Today's subject is master your senses. Sutra, Patanjali Yoga Sutra, 3rd chapter, 48th verse. Grahana Swarupa Asmita Anvaya Artharatva Samyama Indriya Jayaha. Swami Vivekananda translates the sutra as, through samyama and the perception by the organs, the knowledge that follows the eye consciousness that accompanies this knowledge, the inherence of the gunas in all of these, and their contributing to the experience of the soul, comes the conquest of organs.
Mastery over the sense organs. By performing samyama on their power of cognition and real nature, egoism, all pervasiveness and functions brings mastery over the sense organs. First, I'll explain. If you master the sense organs, what happens to you? Then naturally you will be inspired to do this. When you master the sense organs, the first thing will happen to you is you will see the whole Jagat as Ishwara, whole universe as God. Yesterday I went to pay my respects and tribute to Bhagavan Satya Sai Baba. His body, after he attained Videha Samadhi, Videha Mukti, after he took Samadhi, his body is there. I went and bowed down, paid my respects. For a second, I saw he is a pure consciousness. I realized one of the great truth in that moment. He is the pure consciousness. If you want God, you can project God on him and see. In the world also, world is a pure reflection of consciousness. It is pure energy of God. You can project demon on the world and see. I have seen there are some people who feel the whole world is there out just to destroy them and cheat them, exploit them. Their parents are conspiring against them. Their friends are conspiring against them. Their relatives are conspiring against them. The person who is walking in the street is conspiring against them. Onlooker is conspiring against them. Their guru is also conspiring against them. There are some people who feel the whole universe, even the ground on which they are standing, is conspiring against them. They want only demon. They see demon all over the world, everywhere. Everything looks like a demon for them. Like these children, whenever there is a darkness, wherever there is a darkness, they feel, oh, devil is there, Bhuta is there. You can project demon in everything and see, or you can project God in everything and see. Or you don't even need to project God. I can say, if you stop projecting, you will see God, that's all. What is easeness? Easeness tatata is God. I went to Arunachala to offer my gratitude and respects to Arunachala. On the way, I went to inaugurate one of our Ananda Sabhas in Osur Ashram. In Osur Ashram, they built a new temple for me and a meditation hall. For a long time they were inviting me to come and bless that. So on the way, just 10 minutes, I decided, I went there and blessed that property and continued. There we have a beautiful library. That property was donated to us by the close disciple of Jay Krishnamurti, follower of Jay Krishnamurti, who was the head of Rishi Valley School. Mr. Balasundaram, a highly principled and spiritually evolved person, there is a beautiful library donated by him. Only one word, there is a board. The moment I saw that word, that went into my system, and it is ringing even now, waiting to come out. It's a word from Jay Krishnamurti: let the listening be your God. I can say this one line not only can lead you to enlightenment. What Patanjali says, mastery over the senses can happen just by this one line, nothing else. See, I'll reveal all the sacred secrets from this sutra. It's a very beautiful process. Systematically, Patanjali explains how the samyama should be done on cognition, real nature, egoism, all pervasiveness, and functions. I'll explain. But the essence of this whole samyama, Jay Krishnamurti has put in one word: let the listening be your God. When you listen to the master, just see how the words come and fall on you, how you take cognition. You see, your cognition is not perfection as on now. You need to understand, you have senses, but you lost sensitivity. Please understand, we all have senses, but we lost sensitivity. When the word comes and falls on us, how the cognition is taken? For example, now so many of you guys, the moment I look at you guys, all I need is just, I need to look and you need to look. Immediately, the Kundalini awakens. Different plane, you start experiencing. And I can say that before you were, Kundalini was awakened, you were not having this experience. It is not that at that time I was not incarnation, you are not disciple. That time also I was incarnation. You were a disciple. How come suddenly now the moment I... So much is happening in your body. And visibly, physically, not even mentally, some imagination, oh, Kundalini snake is rising. No. Visibly. How come this was not happening 1 year before and happening now? Because your cognition has developed. Your cognition has become pure. Your sensitivity is heightened. Just see if you see in the movies, almost all movies will have this scene. The saris will fly in the air and come and settle down. This is one of the great symbol of romance. Just like how something flies in the air, comes and settles, same way, the words which I am uttering flies in the air and comes and settles on you. Don't take cognition quickly, in a hurried way, no. When that sari lands on you, just layer by layer remove. Oh, now he is uttering a word, cognition. What it means, what he wants to convey, means keeping the buddhi and the decision making dhi. See, buddhi means the energy of you which makes meaning out of all the words. Dhi means the energy of you which decides how to respond to these words. When I am uttering these words, one part of you makes meaning. The other part immediately decides, so today onwards I will practice this. Or the third part will, I heard this about this already 10 times, I cannot practice, you forget about it, we will put this in the archives. Later on we'll practice. Or you will say, this fool has no other work, goes on blabbering something every morning, and I also somehow get attracted to come and sit in front of him. I don't know what to do, but I have to listen. Some cognition, some decision making happens in your dhi. That decision making instrument is called dhi. That energy is called dhi. Do not allow buddhi and dhi to function unconsciously. I am not saying you should take the decision of following whatever I am talking after this session. No. You just be aware. Your dhi and buddhi will take the decision. If your dhi and buddhi takes the decision, you will not have conflict in following what I am saying. When your dhi and buddhi takes the cognition and operation, does the operation in unconsciousness, you go on doing things unconsciously. When the unconscious cognition is encouraged by you and spoken as a conversation, that strengthens the cognition. And if it is again and again spoken as conversation, then it gets strengthened as conversation. Then again and again when the conversation is used, it becomes engram. Understand? How the unconscious cognition becomes conversation and samskara, engram. Come back to be sensitive. Come back to be sensitive. Fall down from foolishness. Actually, when you fall down from foolishness, you will always fall into the intelligence. And trying to take cognition through all five senses just from foolishness. It is such a basic lesson, that is why Patanjali is repeating this lesson again and again and again. Patanjali is one of the greatest inner scientists. Man who demonstrated the science of enlightenment. Even after he left the body, he did not deteriorate or die or show any symbols of death. It was just living, alive, radiating the presence. The disciples don't know what to do. So they just kept his body and built a room around him. He is the only master whose body is not buried with sand or salt or bay leaf. Usually masters' bodies are buried, filling the ash, bay leaves, salt. His body is not buried at all. His body is just kept, and a big stone room is built. Now, all of you guys will be going. I think many of you guys will be going to Rameshwaram. I'll tell our brahmacharis to take you guys to that samadhi place where his room is there. It's a huge room, stone room. Sealed room where he is sitting inside, still you can listen the breathing sound. Again, the big problem is you will think that I am promoting some fantasy. Still you can experience his breathing sound. At least I have experienced. And whoever went and put their ears, don't think, usually if you put your ears on any wall, you will hear a kind of a sound. It will not be like that. Put your ears on this wall and listen. This sound will be different. And go and put your ears on that wall is samadhi. A very systematic, clear breathing sound. How you will feel? You are breathing. That way you can feel. Is living there. Is jiva samadhi is there. He became one with Nataraja. That is why the Nataraja's murti is installed there. And he loved to wear the sacred beads, Rudraksha. So that whole hall is decorated with Rudraksha. They made a Rudraksha mantapa in his memory. And Nataraja, he did not want his own murti to be installed, but the disciples put his murti also in the side. But as a main deity, he became a Nataraja. So he became one with that. Chidakasa Chitampara Nataraja. So his Nataraja's murti is there, and side his murti is also there, his form. The form with which he operated in the body, that body is also there. If you are helped by yoga in any form, you are indebted to him. Anybody wants to experience his presence should go there. You should not miss the opportunity of going to Rameshwaram. Even if you are not able to go this time, you need to go back. Sometime when you come back again, don't miss. Mark it as a point to go to Rameshwaram and see his physical presence. We have some of the great masters' physical body retained as it is, mummified. Not the mummifying of the Egypt way. Egyptian way of mummifying is totally different. They are able to only maintain the body. Our guys are able to maintain the body as the center of the cosmic or conscious functions. When the Vedic tradition way of mummifying happens, not only body doesn't get spoiled and it stays, it continues to be the center of their conscious operations. The cognition is taken, buddhi works, the works, responses happen, they continue to be the center of their conscious activities. That is why your prayers are fulfilled in their presence. If you pray to a mummy, your prayers will not be answered. Because the physical part is retained, but not the response part. Here, the response part is retained. The pure cognition, Dhi and Buddhi is retained. And same way, Srirangam, still Ramanujas, whatever, Ramanujas, Acharya's body is there as it is. You can see the nails growing, the finger, sorry, the hand lines, the palm lines, the eyebrow hairs, all that you can see even now. And not only that, you can feel his presence. You can offer any prayers, you will see the response. You can talk to him. I am telling you from my experience, because I have been helped, I am telling you this. Many times I told, the Arunachaleshwara temple, the Arunagiri Yogeshwara Samadhi is there. He is in Jiva Samadhi. Jiva Samadhi means he is residing there. Shiva himself came down as Arunagiri Yogeshwara. He is residing there. When we went this time, I just wanted to let the world know that really he is there, is Jiva Samadhi is there. All I said is, if he is really sitting here in Jiva Samadhi, let few of his hair come. Get materialized in our devotee's hand so that we can do the DNA test and prove it is 2000 year old DNA and he is alive sitting there in Jiva Samadhi. We got 6 hair. It is there. And we are now sending it for DNA test. Now we are sending it for DNA test. We will prove it. It is 2000 year old, at least 2000 year old. So through that way, at least my one statement is proved. Somebody 2000 year old is sitting down in Jiva Samadhi. Of course, we can't compare because there is no record of Arunagiri Yogeshwara's DNA. But at least this we can prove. Anyhow, when you live in the body, if you arrive to the sensitivity where the buddhi and the functions in awareness and sensitivity, even after you leave the body, that will continue to be there with you, radiate through your body and through you. That is why when you go to the great masters, samadhis, jiva samadhis, whatever prayers you offer, it directly helps you. Immediately they respond to it. Some of these masters' presence, all seekers should experience. The great jiva samadhi of Ellamalla Sittar in Madurai, and Meenakshi's presence in Madurai, and Patanjali's presence in Rameshwaram, Ramanujar's presence in Srirangam, Kamakshi Kamakshi, is Devi herself came and did tapas towards Shiva and became enlightened. Kamakshi's presence in Kanchipuram, all these major masters, energy fields, they all radiate the highest sensitivity. Understand? I saw so many of you guys in the Tiruvannamalai temple levitating, rolling, and receiving vibhuti in their hands. How many received vibhuti in Tiruvannamalai temple? 2-3 people came and reported me. 1-2. Receiving vibhuti in your hands. Understand, you need to know, this is a solid confirmation. Your experience is super conscious experience. If you are receiving vibhuti because of some black magic or yakshini vidya or some unconscious siddhis, it will not happen inside the energy field, garbha mandir of the great incarnations, masters like Arunagiri, Ishwara, Shiva. If it is happening there, understand, the energy which is responsible for all these extraordinary experiences in you, and the energy which resides as Shiva, Arunagiri Yogeshwara, in the temple is one and the same. Achala Murti is Sachala Murti. Because in the super conscious energy field, the unconscious black magic cannot interfere. Let the listening be your God. Today learn this one basic truth. Then I'll explain different sacred secrets from the sutra. When the words come and fall on you, see how the cognition is taken, how the decision is made. Be aware of buddhi and these function. Come back to sensitivity. You can start mastering the senses. I'll continue on the sutra for next few more days. Now, let this be the essence of today's message. Let the listening be your God. I bless you all. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, and share the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.
Trust in you, 'cause you know it's best for me to lead a blissful life, a life with no more strife. I can't believe the things I do, just to spend a little time with you. Nothing will compare, I know you will take care.
You're always showing us compassion, your love is endless like an ocean. Nityananda, Nityananda, my life's become a meditation. If this is, we had a deep connection. Nityananda, Nityananda.
Oh, every time I see
you,
my consciousness expands.
Oh,
my heart begins to dance.
And
every time I think of you, I just start to melt.
So